The Asian century is upon us, and never is this more pronounced than when we see Instagram kids who are better players than we'll ever be. Sam Perry, you've brought something to our attention, the world's attention.
Well, it wasn't me, he goes. It was Raju Devendran via LinkedIn. What am I doing on that site? On that hell site? I don't know either.
The state of it.
I just click it and I use my fingers. Is there any notifications there?
Yep.
Anyway, he brought it to my attention.
Okay.
We've seen this style of video before, he goes, but we figured given the, I guess the phenomenon of the Asian century and the fact that we must now, we've been saying this for a few months now, we must now bend the knee.
Must bend the knee.
To the Asian century. We thought we would just try and deconstruct this video and what we're seeing.
Let's have a look.
Not just what this child is doing physically, biomechanically, but what he's doing to us psychologically across the Anglosphere
I felt some things.
And the world at large.
I felt some things.
Okay. So shall we have a look?
No further ado.
Click.
Away we go. Well, straight away, he's just fucking played the best shot I've never played.
And this is the thing you want to say.
What the fuck is that? Look at that.
This kid's 9, apparently.
Okay.
He may have been younger when this was filmed.
Late bloomer.
His name's Vignaj Prajith from Kerala. His dad says he's not only a batsman, but a fine leg spinner too. So let's have a look at that.
He's actually more of a leg spinner. He's like watching the sun. He's actually more of a bowler.
So basically what happened was he watched the IPL in 2019, picked up the game, said, okay, went onto the roof of the apartment complex. Yeah. Dad's built him a net.
Yeah, of course.
And he gets up at 5 a.m. every morning and practices for 3 hours. He's already done more practice than the entirety of our population at that age.
Okay, but to be fair, wearing whites while training. Fucking village.
That's a very good point. Village. And that's something he'll want to think about.
A five pound on the outside. Yuck. Yeah.
But he goes.
Yeah.
Oh
my God.
He's fucking playing on dry.
On dry, what? That one's slightly on the up. Fucking hell. Look at that.
What about the coordination of the thing? Like at that age. Can I be really clear for a second?
Please.
I'm not.
Please be clear.
There's no hyperbole.
Yeah.
I and I haven't really seen you play that much.
Sure.
Could not look that good.
Yeah.
Hitting throwdowns, hitting half volleys. Like literally the alignment, the shapes, the biomechanics of it, the way he accesses both areas.
Mate,
it is extremely talented.
Who has a trigger movement back and across when they're 9?
Because he's just watched it on the IPL.
It's Coley.
And it's back and across and a light front foot press without committing to it.
Mate, moving the head towards the bowl, like the bowl.
The bowl.
Which is what I call it because I've never played cricket
before.
That's
right. Oh, good bowl.
Fuck, that one's on the up as well. He's just walking at it.
Son, can you just play a few straight drives but keep walking at the bowl
afterwards? My God. Yeah, you got to let them know.
Yeah.
Some of these are quite full, to be fair. I mean, they do need to be put away.
Exactly.
Let's be clear on that.
A little bit of a flourish. Little leg in the air. Look at that.
Mate.
Normally you can't, at that age especially, hit on the offside then access the leg side really that, especially in the 360 that he can. He's just overbalanced there.
Yeah.
But and that's something to have a look at.
Okay, well Pez, here's how I'm feeling. Mm. First of all, like...
How does it make you feel?
Well, it must be nice having a roof to play on. Second of all, I just made a Donny helicopter shot there.
Hello.
Yeah, falling over there.
Yeah, and just roll afterwards. See, you're 9.
Okay, first of all, he's only dealing in boundary, so he's not really building in the innings here. You know, 4s are all well and good. He's got to turn the strike over.
Yeah, that's a good point.
Because there's a kid at the other end who's 8, who's better. He's left-handed. But I'm seeing a lot of stuff full. I'm seeing a lot of full balls.
But he's playing shots there where he has to basically put his head right next to the ball to flip it over leg stump.
Yeah.
Another shot that I've never been able to play. Like, you got all these blokes online, these, like, Australian great cricketers going, try and bump him. It's like, mate, do you see him pick up that pull shot off a length?
Yeah.
He's got no problem with the ball coming close to him.
Yeah, no dramas with that.
You bowl there, he'll destroy you.
So what we have to do is here, we have to mentally disintegrate him. That's the way we're going to get him.
It's the only way. Yeah. I just think his front foot's just pointing a little bit squarer than it wants to be, but that's okay. We can work on that. Oh, look at that. Unbelievable shape. I'm scared. I'm scared.
How does that make you feel?
I feel scared. Mm-hmm. And, you know, when I'm scared, I'll lash out.
Mm-hmm.
So actually, I reject what I said before, bump him.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So there's a story in the 7:30 report today about a guy who's 91 years old who's still going around. It's a great story, really heartwarming story, tugs at the heartstrings and some other stuff.
Mm.
But that's you know, Gary isn't going to play the next Ashes series. This kid isn't going to play the next Ashes series either, but for different reasons.
That's the thing.
This is the future. And how many of these Instagram kids you see all the time on the internet?
Steve Waugh put a documentary out a few months ago, which is really heartwarming, kind of a journey around India. He's doing a little bit of that sort of stuff. Took some photos.
Yeah.
Sold the book for a fair amount of money for charity.
Right.
And the most authentic part of that it for me. Yep. Well, all these blokes are bowling at Steve Waugh. Some of them are on one leg and stuff, and he's just crunching them over cover. which is really authentic Steve Waugh.
Yeah.
And the best part was when they visited like a 2 or 3 year old prodigy like this, and Steve Waugh's like, this kid's amazing. He's really good.
Yeah.
And then they tried to get the kid who, like, I've got a 3 year old. Right. And they tried to get this kid to like play in front of Steve Waugh, and all this kid wanted to do was just whack him on the leg with the bat. It's the only time I've ever seen Steve Waugh like corpse laughing. Properly broke him. You know, like, you watch Steve Waugh when Shane Warne takes a hat trick. That doesn't open
him
up.
He walks over. He just walks over to the huddle. Yeah.
Australia's done this. The 7:30 report's got a great story out about a 91-year-old who's still playing cricket. All these comments under this is wonderful. Yeah. And India's putting this out. This is why the Asian century will take its toll. Yeah. We're telling stories about 90-year-olds.
Yeah, exactly. Well, it's something. Oh, a little bit uppish there. A little bit uppish. Yeah. There's a flourish there.
Like, he needs to work on it.
Okay, he's obviously batting with a stump. We haven't even touched on that. And he's batting with a stump and he's middling every single one of these. Like, okay, it's obviously been clipped together. So it is a little bit like, you know, YouTube.
How many is he missing?
Yeah. What about the ones he's missing?
Exactly.
Yeah.
Mate, if you did that with me with one stump, you'd see Nightfall with the amount that I need to hit.
Different seasons, exactly. Bit of snow in the background.
And I was a good player.
Yeah. there's a celebration in the end there.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Not humble at all.
He's got dead eyes as well. It looks like he's got a lot of hundreds.
Well, his dad's
which is what you need.
His dad's lost an arm there, giving throwdowns for weeks and years on end.
No shoulder. All the comments underneath. So Greg Shippard wrote underneath here. Yeah. So for those who don't know, he coached Victoria. He played for WA. Mm-hmm. Coached Sydney Sixers. He wrote, I see a very bright future for Vignaj. Excellent technique, awareness of strokes he can play. Mm-hmm. If I was running around your team or IPL franchise, I would think a scholarship is entirely appropriate. And apparently Rajasthan Royals got in touch. I don't know what's happened down
there.
Other guys underneath. And this is LinkedIn, so people do proper partnerships on LinkedIn.
Well,
definitely real people.
Interesting.
Not robots.
That's right. Yeah, no robots.
Saying an Australian guy was like, oh, we'd love to send him some gear, some equipment.
A bit of gear.
This kid, some cricket equipment.
Right, okay.
So the kids, just the shapes and the physicality, the way he does it is amazing. It's all everything else down the track for this kid or whatever. Yeah. You've got to work through it. But the biomechanics are unbelievable and the talent. Yeah. That's real. That's real talent.
Well, here's Australia's response that I found on Twitter this afternoon. Greg Blewett catching balls from his son playing golf. There we go. Be scared, guys. Be scared.